Greetings, wizards. Welcome to this monumental video where I rank all the shouts in Skyrim. There are 20 shouts in Skyrim to be exact. A further 3 are found in the Dawnguard expansion, and an additional 4 can be learned in the Dragonborn expansion. In today's video, I am going to cover all 27 shouts and rank them accordingly. This is of course in my own opinion, and may vary depending on your own build, approach, your opinion in general, and many other factors. But nevertheless, I'd love to know your thoughts in the comments below. Just before we begin, I'd like to clarify a few things. This ranking is based solely on the third tier of all shouts, and so doesn't include the first and second tiers. Additionally, perks and attributes that buff the standard shout are not covered, thankfully. Otherwise, this video would probably be double its length, and that's not good for you, and certainly not for me. Nevertheless, I really hope you enjoy this video. Now, let's kick things off. Starting the list at number 27, we have Kind's Peace. Kind's Peace is theoretically great. It helps relax all hostile animals in the Dragonborn's vicinity, providing an easy escape before wearing off. You can rest easy and take in the beauty of Skyrim, knowing that you'll be just fine. What's that I hear? Ah, a frickin' frost troll. Forgot to mention that these boys are exempt from its effects. How convenient. While it may have its uses, and you think you're doing a good deed, you're not, and wolves will continue to attack the locals and feast on the chickens. Furthermore, animal allegiance is a better alternative. We'll get to that later on. 26. Call of Valor. The Call of Valor allows you to summon a hero from the Hall of Valor to fight alongside you for 60 seconds. While the heroes do look pretty cool, you're unlikely to need the extra help in combat once you complete the main questline. And if you do, there's plenty of better alternatives to choose from. Jamoras, Atronax, followers, so on and so forth. Additionally, Call of Valor only summons one of the 3 heroes, and will replace any and all summons currently active. The same goes for the reverse. Considering these facts, it would have been so much better if all 3 heroes could join you into battle. 25. Dismay. Dismay scares the Dragonborn's enemies and causes them to flee from conflict. While great for the lower levels, you generally want the higher level enemies fleeing too, but unfortunately, that isn't the case. Dismay also does not affect undead, Daedra, machines, or dragons, which further limits its usefulness, and sooner or later it becomes completely outclassed by illusion magic, hysteria, and rout. 24. Stormcall. The Stormcall shout creates a heavy downpour accompanied by a fierce thunderstorm directly above the Dragonborn. Powerful bolts of lightning are thrown down upon anyone underneath. When they say don't try it at home, I'm really emphasizing that with this one. It will hit and most likely kill citizens, friendlies, followers, chickens and cows, and if used in or around a town, what follows? A massive bounty, possibly 20,000 septims if let off in a large city, and if you can't pay it off, you're going to jail, son. But maybe not in this case. In addition to that, it can only be used outside, which kind of makes sense, seeing as it's a storm, but would have been awesome if an indoor cloud of violence slowly began to form. Nevertheless, if you are at a fort, and the rare instance calls for it, let it wreak havoc. 23. Animal Allegiance.
Run! Mita!
The Animal Allegiance shout will call nearby animals to aid the Dragonborn against any enemies for 60 seconds. At full power, the effect has a 250 circular area range, and while not particularly useful in practice, it can be great in helping you to defeat giants and Falma. Just use it near some mammoths, spiders, or chorus, and simply watch on from a distance. By the time you actually unlock this shout though, animals generally do not pose much of a threat, and so saving a limited supply of dragon souls for other shouts is recommended. 22. Throw Voice. Throw Voice causes the shout to be heard on a surface the Dragonborn is aiming towards. Enemies will often go to investigate the sound and will gather in one place, allowing it to be used as a distraction to sneak right past them. The shout has a limited range and only fools those who have not yet spotted you, and so unfortunately doesn't affect non-hostile targets. 23. However, it's pretty convenient for your stealth builds, especially since the cooldown makes it essentially free to use. 21. Frost Breath. Frost Breath shouts a force of ice in front of the Dragonborn within a 40 to 50 feet range, and enemies within the area of effect suffer powerful frost damage for 5 seconds. While you may fancy your odds against one or two enemies, having three or more join the party is certainly a crowd, and a pack of enemies can work collectively to slay even the seasoned adventurer. Using Frost Breath helps to level the playing field, as it drastically reduces your target's mobility, setting you up for a good counter-strike or an open window for retreat. On the downside of things, damage-based shouts like this ultimately have the issue of not being able to scale with you, so by the later levels, their damage becomes pretty insignificant. 20. Fire Breath. Similarly to Frost Breath, the Fire Breath shout gives the Dragonborn the ability to deliver a forceful blast, but as its name suggests, fire is involved and spreads at a high speed. 22. It particularly affects a wide range of susceptible enemies, sets them alight, and causes them to stagger. Foes that are susceptible to fire damage include vampires, frost atronachs, frost dragons, draugr, ice wraiths, and we can't forget about those pesky trolls. Again, the downside of this shout is that its damage does not scale with your level. 19. Drain Vitality. Drain Vitality drains 5 points of stamina, magicka, and health from an enemy for 30 seconds, and features a 0.8 stagger effect. I know what you're thinking. If it drains these attributes, you must be able to absorb them. I'm afraid not. It's just a drainer and is best for the early to mid levels. Enemies only get stronger as you progress, and unfortunately, the effects of drain vitality will eventually begin to dwindle.
18. Battle Fury.
Battle Fury benefits your allies by providing them with an enchantment that boosts the speed of their attacks for 180 seconds. While technically this sounds great, it doesn't take long to figure out that the reality is far less impressive than the premise. Let's be honest, most allies are rather useless in a fight, and even on a good day, they just get in the way of where you're going and can just straight up cramp your style. Most prefer to stay true to the lone nature of the Dragonborn, and generally speaking, followers are better off being used as tanks, absorbing the damage from your enemies, which further negates the use for this shout. And just to note, if your follower already has an enchanted weapon equipped, Battle Fury will have no effect. 17. Disarm. At full power, Disarm will pull the weapon out of an opponent's grasp up to level 30. Enemies affected will be staggered and will usually run around like headless chickens to try to find another weapon, unless of course they have a backup in their inventory. I must admit, it can be pretty entertaining to watch powerful enemies scamper around while they look for their snatched weapon. While it gets the entertainment award, this shout is far from reliable, and enemies will often find other weapons lying around. Nevertheless, this shout works on Draugr up to the Scourge level, including the rare Draugr Overlord.
16. Call Dragon.
Call Dragon summons Oddaving to fight alongside you, but unlike summon Durnavir, it can only be used outdoors. After shouting all three words, there will be a short delay, and then Oddaving will arrive at your location. With all the hostile dragons roaming the lands, it can leave you feeling a little overwhelmed, so the power to summon your very own dragon to the fight is incredibly appealing. He's invincible and cannot be killed, only temporarily downed, and won't leave your side until you are out of combat, making this shout particularly useful in difficult fights. The slight issue concerning this shout is that Oddaving takes far too long to arrive. You're either dead or more or less wrapping things up by the time he gets there. In my opinion, you're better off unlocking Summon Durnavir. It is the better alternative.
15. Cyclone.
Cyclone fires out a small windstorm that throws enemies, even large enemies like giants, into the air, causing moderate damage. When all three words are known, the area of effect and range reach their maximum and inflict 100 points of damage to your opponents. While range may be an important factor for archers and mage builds alike, you'll want to have your melee weapon at the ready, so you can pounce when it's used. Victims of Cyclone will fall to the ground after being thrown upwards, and will take a moment to regain their stance, presenting an opportune moment to advance on the enemy. Its ability closely resembles that of Unrelenting Force, Ofusoda, for short, but Cyclone typically deals more damage in situations where huge cliff drops aren't available. 14. Elemental Fury. So? Elemental Fury utilizes the speed of wind to increase a melee weapon's attack speed by 100% for 15 seconds. That doubles the speed of all melee weapons in the game, except it doesn't affect enchanted weapons. However, weapons like Valdir's Lucky Dagger and the Long Hammer do not count as being enchanted, so you can stack the effects and swing a two-handed Warhammer faster than most one-handed weapons. Additionally, as long as you have an unenchanted weapon in your left hand, you can dual-wield Elemental Fury with an enchanted weapon in your right hand, performing insanely quick power attacks. With that being said, the slow time shout, in my opinion, is a better alternative, as it can also be used on bows, crossbows, spells, and bound weapons too, and of course, works with enchanted weapons. 13. Clear Skies. Clear Skies gives the Dragonborn the ability to remove all weather effects from their game, and is also required to clear the wind barriers between High Hrothgar and the Throat of the World. Skyrim is well known for its luscious beauty. Bright blue skies, fresh looking grass, and crystal clear waters. But with that comes heavy downpours, raging storms, and menacing weathers. The effect with all three shouts only lasts 60 seconds, but with a recharge rate of just 15 seconds, this shout can be used repeatedly to give you the best looking weather all year round. Not a useful shout by any means, and you either hate it or love it, but it's one of my personal favourites. Whirlwind Sprint. What? Nakast! Whirlwind Sprint grants the ability to dash forward at great speed. The distance travelled depends on how many words of the shout are used, and using two words actually has the best distance to recharge ratio, being 75 feet and 25 seconds. Its usefulness comes when attacking or defending. You can use it to charge at archers and mages that shoot from a distance, and you can also retreat quickly when that health bar nears its end. It's a lifesaver in both circumstances, and if you're fat on goods, can also be used even when over-encumbered. Ice Form. Yes, Manus! Ice Form encases foes in a solid block of ice, which renders them completely immobile for 60 seconds. Damage is also dealt to the target over time, but if the enemy is hit when frozen, they can break free. The area of effect is also rather narrow, but multiple enemies can be struck if standing side by side, or immediately in front or behind each other. So if you've got a group of enemies all clustered together, this is a great icebreaker. 5. Additionally, frozen enemies tend to fall over due to their loss of balance. And like Cyclone, this gives you the perfect opportunity to swoop in and deal some damage. Though, if your health is at risk, it can also provide you with a moment to flee the scene. 10.
10. Summon Durnavir.
I rejoice in my freedom.
Unlike the call dragon shout, summon Durnavir works like a conjuration spell. Aim it at the ground, ensure there's enough space, and summon away. Durnavir can also be summoned within certain enclosed areas, such as caves, as long as there is enough room. He uses Frost Breath, Drain Vitality, and a unique shout that summons a Bone Man, a Mist Man, and a Wrath Man. The only downside to Durnavir is that he has a 5-minute cooldown, which is a fairly steep cost, but who would pass on the opportunity to have a vicious, undead, frost-breathing beast at just a call away? Not me.
9. Dragonrend.
Dragonrend weakens a dragon and forces it to land after experiencing the overwhelming concept of mortality. It is said that dragons lose their focus on flying due to the knowledge that the shout contains. It tears at their very soul and causes them to land. This shout is situationally essential when you're fighting dragons, and you don't want to be firing your bow and spells hopelessly into the air when Jurzar Vrul can bring them down with haste. You can also use Dragonrend repeatedly to keep dragons permanently on the ground, and amazingly, only the first word of this shout needs to be known to be able to do this. But like every other shout, the more you know, the stronger it becomes, and in this instance, the duration increases. Without this shout, you're stuck playing cat and mouse until the dragon's health reaches 50%. Only then will they automatically land.
Get it now.
8. Soul Tear.
Soul Tear, at full strength, rips the soul out of its victims with Soul Trap, drains their health for 300 points, and if the target dies within 2 seconds, it resurrects their lifeless corpse to fight for you for a whole minute. This just sounds like an absolutely horrific way to die, and to further add to its power, any being up to the level of 100 can be reanimated. Up to 100! That's correct, you can even use it on the Ebony Warrior. But then, there's not much point. This is also great for dealing damage to dragons at the lower levels, but unfortunately, it doesn't resurrect them. Nice try.
Seven, Dragon Aspect.
Dragon Aspect gives the Dragonborn an ethereal set of dragon armor that gets physically applied to the arms, chest, and head. At full power, it improves attack damage by 25%, armor rating by 100, and shout recharge time by 20% for 300 seconds. Left out of its description, the third tier of Dragon Aspect also enhances shouts with point values. For example, Frost Breath by 25%, and shouts with duration values, for example, Elemental Fury by 50%. This can make for some deadly shout combinations, and can even be used in conjunction when in Vampire Lord or Werewolf form.
Epic.
And just when you thought it was over, if at least 2 words of Dragon Aspect are known, and your health is below 50%, an ancient Dragonborn is automatically summoned to fight alongside you. The only downside to this shout is that it can only be used once a day. But with such power, this only makes sense. 6. Bend Will. Just like Mirak, the Bend Will shout allows the Dragonborn to tame and ride dragons. How can I serve you? 2 words, enemies can also be turned into allies for 30 seconds. So theoretically, you could use this shout instead of Dragonrend to slaughter dragons for their souls, while their mind is under full control. Rather messed up if you ask me, and the same goes for humans too, giving this shout some seriously creepy potential. 5. The undead are unfortunately immune to the effects of Bend Will. Nevertheless, anything that tames a hostile creature is always useful when fighting a group of enemies, which is why Bend Will is so incredibly powerful. 5. Aura Whisper. Similar to the Detect Life spell, but better, Aura Whisper reveals anything that moves, including NPCs, creatures, automatons, and the undead. With a range of 300 feet indoors and 500 feet outdoors, having this shout is very reassuring, especially when delving deep into dungeons. No more deadly ambushes. 4. Slow time. Slow time affects the environment. Everything apart from the Dragonborn is slowed down by 90%. Creatures, NPCs, and objects are affected, and are much slower than usual, allowing you to hit and move at a much faster rate than them. So essentially, you're Neo from the Matrix. With 3 words, slow time lasts just 16 seconds, but this is more than enough time to flee the scene, deal some heavy damage, heal up, charge spells, and even catch flying arrows. Only the skilled can do that though, doesn't look like it's me. I'll stick to magic. You can also use it off the battlefield to prolong the effects of your enchanting and smithing potions. In conclusion, this shout is all-rounded and will suit more or less any occasion. 3. Marked for Death. Marked for Death drains the health by 3 points, and damages the armor of its victim by 75 points per second, making them extremely vulnerable to any physical damage. With a duration of 60 seconds, that's 180 points of health damage and 4,500 points of armor damage. But that's not it. If you don't have the unofficial Skyrim patch mod installed, the effect that Marked for Death has on an enemy's armor will be permanent throughout the rest of your game. Also, if you repeatedly use the shout on an enemy, their armor values will become negative, thus increasing your damage output immeasurably, allowing even for a single punch to kill the strongest of foes. 2. Become ethereal. Become ethereal makes the Dragonborn spectral in appearance, and bestows the ability to be invulnerable to all damage for 18 seconds. In addition, stamina will not be depleted while this shout is active. However, if any damaging attacks or spell casting are performed, the effects will end immediately. Regardless of this, I personally find this shout's purpose better suited for positioning rather than attacking. Are you a melee warrior trying to gain ground on a mage or archer? No problem. Are you a ranged assailant trying to increase the distance between you and the enemy? Not an issue. Become ethereal also boasts a range of additional advantages, and to name my favourites, you can quickly descend mountains faster than a mountain goat. The small window of invincibility allows you to prepare your master spells without interruption. And using the various spell cloaks before shouting will still inflict damage onto your enemies. Overall, a truly magnificent shout. And if you haven't already guessed it, it's Unrelenting Force.
Force, brother!
Tried and true, and almost always effective in combat, unless fired into a ward, Unrelenting Force brings power, entertainment, and nostalgia back into Skyrim. There's just something about launching an enemy off a cliff and watching their corpse ragdoll against the jagged rocks that I'll never quite understand. It just doesn't get old, and I don't want it to either. Fushuza was the first shout we ever heard in Skyrim, and to not have it at number one would be a dishonor. With all three words, you can blast away a group of enemies with ease, creating an opening for attacks before they recover, or presenting that window of opportunity to take your leave. Brilliant in attack and in defense. If you've made it this far, respect. You are a true wizard, and I implore you to leave a like and subscribe. On a side note, the support I've been receiving recently has just been awesome, and I'd like to thank each and every one of you for keeping me motivated. And I apologize for the lack of videos recently. I've literally been working on this video for the entirety. But if I decide to create a video of this magnitude again, I will definitely produce other content alongside it to keep up with the regular uploads. Nevertheless, you can expect plenty more top-notch Skyrim content just like this in the future, and you know what to do to stay in the loop. And question of the video, what's your favourite shout and why? Let me know in the comment section below. This has been the Welsh Wizard, and I shall see you in the next one.